Hey everybody, AJR Music coming at you with another guitar lesson. Today we're going to talk about the guitar solo from Logan Ledger's Let the Mermaids Flirt with Me. This is my signed copy right here. If you haven't picked up this album yet, the self-titled album that came out this year, go and grab it. It's awesome. It's got tons of great country guitar going on and great songwriting, and I just love it. Can't stop listening to it. If you haven't already, check out my rhythm guitar lesson video on this same song, which I'll link to right here. If you want tabs for this solo or any of my videos on my channel, check out my Patreon page, which I'll link to on screen in the description and pinned in a comment. I'm also going to link to a free Nashville number chart for this song in the description, so check the description for that link. Before we get started, if you like what I'm doing on my channel and you want to support me, give me a like and a subscribe. That would really help me out, and I'm trying to get to 500 subscribers before the end of the year. All right, let's get right into it. Here's the guitar solo from Let the Mermaids Flirt with Me by Logan Ledger. We're just going to take this lick by lick, so our first couple notes are going to outline our D major chord. Okay, so that's just our D major pentatonic going from 5, sliding from 7 to 9 on the A string, and then you're going to go 7 or 9-7 on the D string, and then you're going to go back to the A string and slide from 9 to 7, ending on 5 on the A string. Let's keep going. Next part. Okay, so we're going to our G chord now. We're going to go chromatically 6, 7, 8, 9 on the D string. And then 7 on the G string, 8 on the B string. Last note is 6 on the E string. That's a G minor triad. Move it up a whole step. A minor. And then landing on a D triad. So that's 7 on the G string, 7 on the B string, and then 5 on the E string. From the beginning. Okay, so that is like an F shape, but at the 10th fret, which makes it a D. So you're gonna rake up to that 10th on the E string and go, that's 14, 13, 12 on the B string. And then we're gonna keep going. So the next part is 10 on the E string again, and then 14, 13, 12, 11 on the B string. Keep going. That's the last iteration right there. We're gonna go 10 on the E string again. 13, 12, 11, 10 on the B string. So that whole thing, chromatic walk down thing. So that last part right there was 10, 9, 10 on the B string. And then that's 9 on the E string. And then a B triad, which is like your F shape, but we're sliding it up to the 7th fret. Keep going. So we are taking a little minor third right here, and we're starting it at the 13th fret on the B string, and then the 11th fret on the E string. And you're going to slide that up one fret to 12 and 14. 13 on the E string. So those are just sixes intervals. We're going to go 14 on the G string and 14 on the E string. Back one fret. And then back one more fret to 12. So from the chromatic walk down on the D, it sounds like this. Okay, keep going, second half of the solo. Pretty much the same. That little walk up to the first note is 5-7 on the E string, and then 6 on the A string. And then our little variation at the end there. You're just hammering on to 7 on the D string, 5 on the D string, and then sliding down to that 5th fret on the A string. Okay, let's keep going. Let's figure that out. We have 9 on the G string. That's 7, 8 on the B string. And then you're sliding 10 to 12 on the B string. And you're going 12 and 10 on the E string for right there. We have that pretty little chord right there. That's 12 on the G string, 11 on the B string, and 12 on the E string. That's 10, 12 on the E string. And that's a D major triad. So that's just your D shape, but it's up at the 14th fret. Let's keep going. Okay, so we have this kind of bluesy riff right here. So we're in our B minor pentatonic. Everybody knows that. So you're playing the high E string on the 10th fret and bending on the G string. Then you're going high E string on the 7th fret. And coming back to that 10th fret on the E string. There's that G major triad again. G minor triad. Let's break that down. That's a D major scale, by the way. So you're doing this triplet hammer-on thing at 6 and 8 on the E string. Moving back to the 5th fret on the E string. So that's 8 on the B string, 7 on the G string, and then that's 5-7 on the B string. That last part, so that's where we left off. So we're starting on that last walk up right there is 7 on the G string. That's 5, 6, B and G string. 7, 5, 7 on the G and the B string. And then you're sliding 9, 7 on the E string. Okay, last part. So you're just going 7, 8, 9 on the B string. And then you have these sixes again. So that is going to be 9, 9 on the G and the B string. 8, 8, 7. So that would just be an A triad, which is like your F, but at the 5th fret. And then back to your D triad at the 10th fret. So I know that's a lot. So hopefully that helped you out. I know I was going quickly, but if I'm going too fast, you can slow down the video on YouTube. And don't forget to check out the tabs on my Patreon, at my Patreon channel, which I'll link to on screen in the description and pinned in a comment. And make sure you get that free Nashville number chart that is in the description. Linked in the description for this song. I hope you enjoyed that. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I'm Alex, and this is AJR Music. Thanks for watching.